Good morning friends, good morning students. Today we will discuss about what to read in university theory examination. There are two papers in MUHS theory examination, paper 1 and paper 2. We will discuss these topics topic wise. For example, in chemistry part, there are chemistry of carbohydrate, protein, lipid and nucleic acid. In carbohydrate chemistry, read these two questions. These are the important questions in carbohydrate chemistry: heteropolysaccharide followed by homopolysaccharide. Then in lipid chemistry, phospholipid, it is an important question along with example and functions of phospholipids. Then essential fatty acids, it is important with their example and their functions. Then in amino acid chemistry, read about the classification of amino acid, that amino acids are classified on the basis classified in four ways. For example, structure wise, polarity, then essentiality and metabolic classification. Then this is the important LAQ, structural organization of protein, that is primary, secondary, tertiary and quaternary structure of protein, along with the bonds which are important for stabilizing the protein structure. This is the very, very important question in protein chemistry. This is LAQ, long answer question. Then this one is the short note, that is denaturation, that is loss of secondary, tertiary and quaternary structure of protein and primary structure remain intact. That is known as denaturation. Then types of RNA. Of these three types, the most important is the tRNA, along with the diagram. This is important short note as well as long answer question, types of RNA. Then DNA, that is Watson and Crick model of DNA, along with the diagram. This is the important short note. Then this is very, very important in biological oxidation, that is electron transport chain. It is very, very important. It is a short note, also it is a part of long answer question. Short note or LAQ. Then this one is very, very important short note, that is chemiosmotic hypothesis, how there is development of proton gradient, and this proton gradient is responsible for generation of ATP. This is described by the chemiosmotic hypothesis or chemiosmotic theory, and it is a very, very important short note in biological oxidation. Then this one, this part, uncoupler, it is a short note as well as this part is very, very important for MCQ point of view. Uncouplers, physiological and chemical uncouplers and inhibitors of electron transport chain and oxidative phosphorylation. This is important for short note and MCQ purpose. Then in hemoglobin chemistry and metabolism, read about the hemoglobin degradation and jaundice. This one is important for the case. Then read about the sickle cell disease, short note, thalassemia, short note, also porphyria, short note. These four topics, jaundice, sickle cell disease, thalassemia and porphyria, this is important topic as cases. There are two cases in paper 1 and two cases in paper 2. Remember jaundice, there are three types of jaundice, pre-hepatic, hepatic and post-hepatic. The hepatic and the obstructive is important. Then sickle cell disease, thalassemia, porphyria, these are the important cases, along with the cases in mineral metabolism and vitamins. Okay, this is about the chemistry part and short notes. Now we'll discuss about the metabolism and very, very important LAQs in metabolism. Coming to the carbohydrate metabolism, these three are very, very important LAQs in carbohydrate metabolism. The first one is the describe the steps in gluconeogenesis with the substrate which are required for the gluconeogenesis. This is the important LAQ. With special emphasis on irreversible steps in glycolysis which overcome by the four enzymes in gluconeogenesis. This is important LAQ first. Second one important is the regulation of plasma glucose level. This is very, very and very frequently asked question. This one is the regulation of plasma glucose. And third one is the glycogen metabolism along with its regulation. Along with its regulation with the help of insulin, with the help of glucagon and adrenaline, noradrenaline, thyroid hormone. These all hormones are responsible for regulation of glycogen metabolism, and this is very, very important in carbohydrate metabolism. Now, then this is the, again, this one is the LAQ, that is fate of acetyl-CoA and fate of pyruvate. These are the two important LAQ in carbohydrate metabolism. So these three are very, very important and frequently asked question in carbohydrate metabolism. Then coming to the lipid metabolism, beta oxidation of fatty acid along with the disorders related to the beta oxidation of fatty acids, then fatty acid synthesis and cholesterol synthesis. These are the LAQ. In short note, in carbohydrate metabolism, this one is the very, very important short note, HMP shunt, because it gives NADPH and pentose sugar. That are very, very important. That's why it is a very, very important SAQ, that is HMP shunt and followed by glycolysis in carbohydrate metabolism. In lipid metabolism, ketone bodies formation and their utilization and starvation, these are important short notes. In coming to the amino acid metabolism or protein metabolism, this one is the frequently asked question, that is formation, transport, disposal of ammonia along with urea cycle and its disorders. This is very, very important question in amino acid metabolism. Then metabolism of phenylalanine and tyrosine, metabolism of sulfur containing amino acid. In short note, phenylketonuria, alkaptonuria, albinism, and this one is the important short note, that is transamination, with silent features of transamination and with example, that is SGOT and SGPT. Then no doubt, this one is very, very important topic in biochemistry, that is enzyme. Don't skip any part of enzyme. It includes classification of enzyme with example, then factor affecting enzyme activity, then diagnostic importance of enzyme, isoenzyme, coenzyme, definition of enzyme, regulation of enzyme activity and mechanism of enzyme action. These all are important topic, and this is very, very important topic in biochemistry, because in most of the institution this topic is covered by professor or HOD, and this is frequent. There are number of questions in enzyme that are frequently asked in examination. Then coming to the nucleotide metabolism, in nucleotide metabolism, read about the gout. This is again a case. Then gout-Leishmann syndrome. These are two important short note, and also it is a part of cases. Then we will discuss about vitamin, mineral, nutrition, genetic, acid-base balance, hormone action, different function tests, detoxification, and various instrument. Before that, we will discuss about some cases. First one is the prehepatic jaundice, then hepatic jaundice, followed by obstructive jaundice. These are the three cases, followed by sickle cell anemia, thalassemia, various porphyria. In this porphyria, the acute intermittent porphyria is important. Then in cases, gout and Leishmann syndrome. These are two important cases. In nutrition, there is case of protein energy malnutrition, that is PEM, that is important, that is marasmus and kwashiorkor. In vitamin, there are number of cases in vitamin, for example beriberi, pellagra, then megaloblastic anemia. In mineral, the calcium deficiency, there is tetany. In iron deficiency, there is iron deficiency anemia. In zinc deficiency, that is acrodermatitis enteropathica. There is goiter due to the deficiency of iodine. There is fluorosis, skeletal fluorosis and dental fluorosis due to the fluoride. This, there are number of cases, and there are two cases in each paper. There are total four cases in paper 1 and paper 2. Now we will discuss about the important topics in vitamin, mineral, nutrition, genetic, acid-base balance. Vitamin, it is very, very important as a short note, and also it is important as a cases. Vitamin A is a important. In vitamin A, the world's visual cycle is one short note, and the night blindness and the conjunctival xerosis, corneal xerosis, corneal degeneration, these are the deficiency manifestations of vitamin A. It is important for short note and case. Then beriberi, pellagra, megaloblastic anemia, These are the cases in vitamin. In mineral, iron deficiency anemia. Then Wilson's disease due to the copper. Then due to deficiency of zinc, that is the skin manifestation, that is acrodermatitis. Enteropathica. Goiter. Deficiency of iodine. And fluorosis. Dental and skeletal fluorosis due to the fluoride. So these are the important cases in vitamin and minerals. The LAQ, important LAQ in vitamin and mineral is vitamin D. Vitamin D, that is rickette and scurvy. These are also important cases, rickette and scurvy. These are the LAQ in vitamin D, vitamin C, vitamin A, and vitamin B12 and folic acid. These are LAQ in vitamin D along with rickette, scurvy, and this is megaloblastic anemia and pernicious anemia. In mineral, the LAQs are the calcium, iron along with iron deficiency anemia. So these two are important LAQ in mineral, and these are important LAQ in vitamin. Then coming to the nutrition, read about the protein energy malnutrition, that is marasmus and kwashiorkor. Read about RDA, recommended dietary allowance. Read about balanced diet. In nutrition, in genetic, read about the replication, protein biosynthesis and transcription. Means replication, transcription and translation. Then read about the lacoperon, that is regulation of gene expression in prokaryote, that is lacoperon. And again read about the recombinant DNA technology and its uses. It is very, very important LAQ. In genetic, read about replication. This is LAQ. Then transcription, translation, then read about lacoperon. This is regulation of gene expression in prokaryote, that is lacoperon. Then there is short note, that is gene therapy. This is short note, gene therapy. And LAQ, important LAQ, these are LAQs. And the important LAQ in this is recombinant DNA technology or genetic engineering with its applications. And again, one short note, important short note is PCR. PCR and DNA fingerprinting. So these are important questions in genetics: replication, transcription, translation, lacoperon, gene therapy, genetic engineering and its application, PCR and DNA fingerprinting. These are important questions in genetics. This is in acid-base balance. It is important how it is how different mechanisms are responsible for maintaining the acid-base balance in our body. It is LAQ. That is acid base balance with disorders. Disorders means that is metabolic acidosis, metabolic alkalosis, respiratory acidosis, respiratory alkalosis. So this is important question. Then in function test, These are the short notes. These are short notes. Function test. The important is LFT. Don't read in detail about LFT. Comment about in LFT, comment about SGOT, SGPT, total protein, albumin, alkaline phosphatase, and bilirubin. You know the practical aspect of these all: SGOT, PT, total protein, albumin, alkaline phosphatase, and bilirubin. Write about these components, these parameters, and write about the clinical significance of these parameter in LFT. This is enough for LFT. In KFT, in kidney function test, you know the clearance. You know the clearance definitions of clearance, and you know the formula of calculating the clearance, that is UV divided by P. And the different parameters which are important are urea, creatinine, sodium, and potassium. Write about this parameter in KFT. In thyroid function test, TFT, in thyroid function test, write about the thyroid gland and hormones secreted by the thyroid gland, and write about T3, T4, TSH, free T3, and free T4 for the diagnosis of hypothyroidism and hyperthyroidism. This is enough for function test. Then coming to the detoxification, this is very, very important short note, detoxification. In detoxification, the phase 2, it is very important. Detoxification or biotransformation, the removal of toxic waste products from our body. In detoxification, the important is phase 2 reactions. Phase 2 reactions. There are two phases, phase 1, phase 2. This phase 2 is important, short note. And the important in phase 2 is the conjugation reaction. You know the example of conjugation reaction, that is bilirubin. It is combined with UDP glucuronic acid and get converted into bilirubin glucuronide or bilirubin diglucuronide and get excreted from the body. This is the example of detoxification with the help of conjugation reaction. So this one is the very, very important detoxification phase 2 reaction. And in instrument, you know about colorimeter. Draw the diagram. Write about the parts of the colorimeter and uses of the colorimeter. Then electrophoresis. This one is the short note. Then chromatography. This one is the short note. And pH meter. And flame photometer. So these are the instrument in your syllabus. There will be short note on this instrument. Colorimeter, write about the parts of the colorimeter, draw the diagram, and write the uses of colorimeter. Electrophoresis, in the electric field, the charged particle moves towards the oppositely charged electrode. This is the electrophoresis and uses of electrophoresis. In chromatography, there are two phases, stationary phase and mobile phase. And different, depending upon the distribution in these two phases, the compound gets separated, and the uses of chromatography. Then pH meter and flame photometer. Flame photometer, it is used for measurement of sodium, potassium, that is electrolytes. So these are the important topics as the exam point of view. If you are in the hurry, read about these important topics. If you want to score near about 80% or more than 80% marks, read about these common things. Read about the cases which are discussed. Which cases we discussed today? The first one is the jaundice, then sickle cell disease, thalassemia, then acute intermittent porphyria. Then we'll discuss the cases in vitamin. Then we'll discuss the cases in minerals. Then protein energy malnutrition, that is marasmus and kwashiorkor. So these are the important cases in biochemistry. They are given in the books. So this is all about the important topics in biochemistry and how to prepare for the examination, theory examination in our university exam in paper 1 and paper 2. So best of luck all the student. Be confident, be sure, and attempt all question. So best of luck and thank you.